We are in Berlin.
Berlin, yeah.
Hello.
Yes.
Welcome. Welcome in.
Finally, you got a chance to meet in a full team.
Yeah. First time I'm. I can meet you personally.
What, like 8 years.
Yeah.
Long time.
Only emails.
Yes.
So far.
Long time.
Yep.
Hello. Pleasure. Thank you for coming.
I'm very, very happy to be here. Tell me something about your tour, current tour. It's only for Germany.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's been great. We haven't been here in, feels like about at least, well, 2019, so 4 years. We've had to reschedule, just like everyone else has had to reschedule. But it's been great. Like, we just did a support tour this last October, but it's been a while since we've been back to Germany playing. Mm-hmm. We've got 2 albums since we've been here last. So that's quite a lot. So it's nice to see, you know, our fans versus, you know, playing for someone else's fans and trying to earn new fans. So it's been great.
Yeah.
Really, really fun. Yeah. Feels good to be doing it properly again.
What instruments are you using on the stage now?
So I'm using the Cardinal, Aquila Cardinal. As of today, I've got 3 now. So we kind of have 3 major main tunings. Mm-hmm. So I've got now 1 for each.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm using Duvels for the F sharp tuning as well. So Cardinal and Duvel right now.
Cool. Great.
The main differences in tone that you found out between those 2 models?
The Duvel's a little bit more of a, like, not nasal, but a bit more of an aggressive sort of sound, whereas the Cardinal's a more full, round, like a balanced sound, which I much prefer. Like, it covers everything really, really nicely.
So yeah, so the Cardinal, your signature.
Mm-hmm. Available now.
Available now.
Shipping
every,
now.
Almost every single
yes.
floor, that's yeah. Adam's Mayones. Why it suits you? Why this design?
Mm-hmm.
What happens? Why this model is the one that you decided to come with a signature model with us?
Yeah. Well, over the years, like I just like anyone else, kind of started on the more traditional stuff, like, you know, Fender type guitars, Les Pauls, that kind of thing. And then as I started playing more aggressive music, you kind of have to specialize your equipment a little more. It's like, okay, maybe, you know, a certain scale length or a certain type of pickup that, you know, obviously guitars that were designed in the 50s were not really meant
mm-hmm.
to do what a lot of bands do today. So kind of started learning more about scale length and trying different guitars over the years, you know, based on different tunings and all this sort of thing. And I always found, for me, the issue with tuning down, and not even like to a huge, crazy, you know, 7 or 8 string level, but just the tension and the tone, because you could have a shorter scale guitar with, you know, a certain gauge string on, and then a longer scale guitar with a lighter gauge string. Both have the same tension as far as, you know, actual measurable tension,
yeah,
but totally different feel and sound. So getting a little bit longer scale, trying to maintain what would be a standard E tuning guitar or something, but be able to have it tuned low. So over the years, just trying different guitars and different brands and stuff. And then back in 2015, when I first discovered Mayones, like, oh, this is a great company. Like, you kind of specialize in, you know, modern progressive builds and things like that. Kind of got into the world of, you know, bare knuckle pickups and coming from different pickups in the past. And I've always really just kind of been, I've never been like a metal guitar guy or, you know, a really extreme design. Like, I've always liked kind of traditional type stuff, but feels modern and you can do whatever you need to as far as tuning, all that sort of thing. And then over the years, kind of experimenting with different Mayones models and, you know, liking little bits of things about each one, maybe the, you know, the comfort of one, the tone of one, and everything in between. I feel like the Cardinal's really kind of that sweet spot where it does everything. It's not too radical looking. It's really, really classy.
Simple.
Simple.
Yeah.
It's familiar, but, you know, mm-hmm. new and improved. You don't have to be a metal player to appreciate mm-hmm. it. Like, you know, the pickups that come with are very versatile, but you could just change the pickups and have a very capable, like, country or a blues guitar, mm-hmm. or like it's like a template, really.
And you can have 2 scales, so 27 and 25 and 4. So everybody can find
for sure.
a good scale for for the own music that you want to
play. Like for a standard scale, you can get away with quite a low tuning, but you know, depending on your physical size, even some people just prefer a standard because the baritones are simply too big. But when you go to the baritone scale, you can get a little bit lighter gauge string on there, and I think achieve a clearer tone. You get you can get a similar tension without it being, you know, massive strings. You get more more attack, and it's just what I like.
Which tuning is the most used in the Architect songs?
So our main tuning is kind of based around a C sharp standard or drop B, so not crazy low. So
what is the gauge?
So what I'm using on the 27 inch is 11 to 56. So not a crazy big gauge, but on a longer scale, it gives you what would feel like drop D in a regular size guitar, right? And then we've also got some songs that are, everything stays the same except for the low string.
Oh, so
a lot of people, when they're not familiar with our music, they just assume we're playing seven strings because of the way it sounds.
Yes, the F sharp.
We've never played seven strings, it's always been six. But the low string drops and kind of gives you like a seven string sound, so you can have that really low stuff, but you get bigger interval skips because the other strings are still the same. So that would go down to a G sharp and a 70 gauge usually. And then we've got some songs that are F sharp down again, that's like a 74. But with a longer scale baritone, it's not flubby and you can still get some nice attack out of it.
Yeah, that's the other thing of the Aquila, that the locking tuners and fixed bridge just sort of keeps it.
No tremolo to worry about, very simple. Yeah, I've always been just, you know, simple. As few electronics you can get away with. It's like a simple hardtail bridge. Just good quality hardware, but just very simple, like nothing fancy.
It's gonna be a great gig.
Yeah.
The venue sounds amazing.
I'm looking forward to it. I'm glad you guys are here.
The
this place is cool. Yeah, I think you're gonna enjoy it.
Oh yeah, we will.
Yeah.
Definitely. Hope to meet you soon in Poland. Yeah.
Yes. Oh, so yeah, we'll be in Poland in July.
Then we're gonna do a live stream.
That'll be good. That'll be good.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Pleasure.
Deception hiding, now you say. Corruption hiding.